Hi, it's Ross Shain with Boris FX. In this tutorial, I'll be diving deep into Optics, the effects plugin for Photoshop and Lightroom. In a series of steps, we'll take this product photo and turn it into something a bit more stylized using color correction, masks, and Optics' excellent render and lighting filters. Let's get started. If you'd like to follow along, please check out the link in the video description. We've provided the source files and a quick start text document to get you started. While this is not a Photoshop cloning tutorial, I will mention that I used some basic paint and clone tools to replace the logo with new text. Both versions are provided if you want to create your own label. We'll start by making sure that our layer is a smart object. Then we'll select Optics from the filter menu, and this will launch the custom interface. Optics has 160 filters divided into categories at the bottom of the screen. Here you can find tools for color correction, blurs, tints, and many effects filters. I'll start by selecting the black and white filter in the color tab. And here we can switch between presets and parameters. Every Optics filter includes both. We can edit the filter's parameters or select presets. I like how the color value-based black and white presets can give different results without having to play with any sliders. Next, let's select the New Layer button in the upper left to add more effects. I'd like to tint the bottle blue, so I'll apply a color gradient from the tint category and tint the midtones blue. Now I can definitely get a similar result using one color correction layer, but as I build up the composite, having more control will help me make creative choices. To isolate our effects, Optics has many masking tools. We'll start with my favorite, the Easy Mask. With simple paint controls, we can add some strokes to select the foreground. The I and O shortcut keys will zoom the canvas in and out, and use the bracket keys to change your brush size. And then we can define the background with some more strokes. We'll click the Generate Mask button to create the Easy Mask. We can select the View Matte button and continue to add and refine to the foreground and background. And we'll select Generate Mask to update. Now that we've tinted the bottle, I'll use the Path Mask tool to draw some simple holdout shapes. And let's make sure the masks are in the right order. You can apply multiple masks in any Optics layer. You can drag the masks to make a copy or switch order. I'll make a second shape for the label. We can hold the Alt key to add a new point or adjust the tension on the handles. And if we like this at this point, next we'll focus on the background. Optics has some great effects generators found in the render category. I'll choose the Caustics filter. Again, we have some nice presets to play with. Let's look at the Caustics parameters and switch the blend mode here to Caustics only. Now we can change the pattern's colors and play with the settings for density, frequency, and complexity settings. This seed parameter is basically a variation style. And we'll switch the combine modes back to add. And we can simply copy our Easy Mask from earlier by dragging it up to this layer. And we'll invert the mask to fill the background with our Caustics effect. Here's a saved Caustics preset that I created earlier. You can star your favorites to add to the favorites folder. And now to make the bottle feel a little transparent, I'll create a few rough path shapes. And then we'll soften and blend the fill in. So we can now see a little of our background bleed through. And again, we can repurpose our holdout mask for the label and the bottle cap. And now we'll add a new layer and get into some fun with the Optics Light category. I'll apply the Aurora filter and switch the blend mode to Aurora only to play with the parameters. While you might think that the Aurora filter is mostly used for night skies or northern lights, it's actually quite a lot of fun to play with as an element generator. When we start to play with the stroke size, the swirling complexity, and the magnitude settings, we can start developing a cool abstract electric-looking element. There are some lighting controls built into the effect, and the color phase changes shift across our element. We'll change our blend mode back to screen And again, copy our Easy Mask and Path Masks up to this layer. And with my masks in place, I can continue tweaking my Aurora effect and dialing in the parameters to a place that I like, think it looks pretty good. And again, I'll want to integrate this layer in more naturally. So I'll create another few shapes to dial the opacity back in a few key areas. While I'm using the spline-based path tool, this could also be done by painting a mask or using the gradient masks. Every mask instance has its own softness and opacity settings, and you can add, subtract, or multiply these mask layers together. To continue finessing this look, I decided to add the S glow effect, also found in the light category. All the optics effects that start with S come from Sapphire, which is Boris FX's collection of plugins for video and film. Sapphire's glow is used regularly in film and TV and can generate really soft and beautiful lighting effects. Again, we can start with a preset and simply make a few changes to our liking. While I do like this background, I do want to separate the foreground and background elements a little more. So we'll look to the diffusion and blurs category. A really nice blur effect here is Sapphire's blur chroma filter, which adds just a subtle blur to the chrominance of my background. And I feel my overall look is getting a little dark, so I picked the reflector effect found in the light category. This effect emulates a silver or gold reflection sheet that a photographer might use on a photo shoot. Just a little touch, and then we'll dial it back down in our layer's opacity to get the look that I'm going for and brighten things up. And of course, the star of the optics lights category is the lens flare effect, again from our Sapphire collection. There are so many great looking presets that it isn't hard to find some nice looking cinematic flares to complement the edit. We can pick an anamorphic preset, match our color, and then roll back the scale and brightness to get just a touch of gloss. And we can stack the flare effects up for some more interesting cinematic flare effects. Optics also has a great search system, so to top the shot off, I'll search for vignette, and then I'll apply the vignette effect to add a little darkness and blur falloff to the bottom of our image. We'll tweak the interactive on-screen controls to adjust the scale, aspect, and position. And once we have our basic image composite all set up, the real power of editing in optics is that every effect parameter and mask in the project is still totally live. I call this procedural image editing, where we can select any effect in the stack and edit any parameter while looking through the entire composite into context. It's a really creative way to work and make choices. And once we're done, we'll simply close optics and the project is rendered right back to Photoshop or Lightroom. Now, if you've watched up to here and you're a Photoshop user who loves the optics effects but prefers the composite in the Photoshop interface, I do have a quick tip and hopefully a useful way to use optics quite differently. We'll start with the base layer, duplicate it, and make it a smart filter. And we'll apply optics. Now I'll apply a black solid from the color category. Let's apply one of the effects, like the lens flare. We can toggle the black fill on and off to see the effect over our image. Leaving the black effect active, we'll exit optics and set the Photoshop layer to screen. With this workflow, it is quite a simple way to work. Create your elements in optics and mask and comp in Photoshop. And that's about it. Inside the download folder, you'll also find a bunch of optics setup files in this Photoshop project that has some fun alternate looks for this product shot. You can explore the optics projects and check out some of my favorite effects. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up and also let us know in the comments the kinds of optics training tips you'd like to see us cover. Cheers.